The female romantic fantasy, the female myth, is Beauty and the Beast. Tameable beast. In the Disney movie Beauty and the Beast, the woman, who's quite a stellar character, right? She's beautiful and she's wise and she's intelligent. She has her choice. Like, she's got Loser, the village man. She's got Narcissist, that's Gaston. And she's got Beast. Now, stupid women like narcissists, naive women like narcissists, because they confuse their narcissism with competence and confidence. That's how narcissists exploit. They look like they're confident. They look like they're competent. Beauty, Gaston is after her, wants to charm her. She goes for the Beast. Well, the Beast is a monster. He's a traumatized monster even. But she hopes that he's tameable, that she can bring him into relationship. And like, a good beast has options, but he'll forgo the options for the relationship. That's the female sexual fantasy. Tameable beast. Now, that's rough, right? Because how likely is it that you're going to be able to tame a beast? Not that likely, but pretty damn useful if you can do it. Then you have someone who can keep the real beasts at bay. Like, women have to negotiate a very tight line because they're looking for men who are disagreeable enough to be able to tell the monsters to go to hell, but who are generous and productive enough to share. That's a hard target to hit. It's a hard target for a man to become, too.
A white man? No!
Barely. Just a little change. So